So hi everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247, where we are going to discuss some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams, especially for the upcoming NABARD grade examination, right? And guys, as you all know, the parliament session has been started now, so there will be a lot of news in the PIB. So from now on, the sessions will be quite longer than the usual sessions. And I am planning, or agar ho sakega, to I will take the sessions regularly as well, because abhi to alternate days pe hote hain, Monday, Wednesday and Friday. But agar zarurat padi, if required, the sessions will be conducted daily from the next week. But if required, alright. So let's begin with the session. And in today's session, there are 17 questions and all the questions are very, very important, right? So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, guys, let me tell you, if you want to have the PDF of this session with marked answers, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. Alright. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, name the seminar organized by Naval Innovation and Indigenization Organization to engage Indian industry and academia towards achieving self-reliance or Atmanirbharta in the defense sector. So you just have to name this seminar, which has been organized by NIIO, which is Naval Innovation and Indigenization Organization. Alright. So let's talk about it. The name of the seminar, guys, is Swavlamban. It is Swavlamban and it has been organized by Naval Innovation and Indigenization Organization. Now, why this seminar was organized? What was the purpose? So, the purpose was to engage Indian industry and academia towards achieving self-reliance in the defense sector. It has provided a platform for leaders from industry, from academia, from government, from NGOs and from other stakeholders to invite the ideas on how we can strengthen the defense sector and specifically the development of technologies, right? Talking more about this, so during the program, the Prime Minister launched Sprint Challenges. Prime Minister ne launch kiya hai Sprint Challenges. Now, what is the full form of Sprint Challenges? It is supporting pole vaulting in R&D through IDEX, NIIO and TDAC. IDEX, I hope you all know this, Innovation for Defense Excellence. NIIO, that organization which has launched this seminar. And TDAC is Technology Development Acceleration Cell, which works under the Ministry of Defense. Now, please remember, there is no need to go into the details of these organizations. That is absolutely not important, right? So this Sprint Challenges stand for this. Now, what will happen under this Sprint project? So basically, NIIO along with Defense Innovation Organization, that is DIO, NIIO or DIO, dono milke, Defense Innovation Organization milke, they will develop at least 75 new indigenous technologies into the Indian Navy. Theek hai? So basically, the idea is to develop 75 new indigenous technologies which will help in the development of Indian Navy, particularly in the manufacturing sector, right? So that is all about this seminar. And now let's come back to the question. The correct answer to this will be option B, Swavlamban, because that is the name of the seminar that was organized by Naval Innovation and Indigenization Organization. All right. So I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Digi Yatra project and you have to identify the correct statement. So you must be wondering, that is that a new project? No, it is not a new project. Then why it is in news? Because recently a consultative committee meeting regarding this project was held by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Remember, this project is being implemented by Ministry of Civil Aviation, which is headed by Mr. Jyotiraditya Scindia, right? So this meeting was held and therefore this Digi Yatra project is in news. Now, what is this Digi Yatra project, by the way? Remember, it is a project which was launched to achieve contactless and seamless processing of passengers at airports. Jo airport pe passengers ka aana jana hota hai, wo pura ka pura contactless ho jaye, iske liye ye project launch kiya gaya tha. And it envisages that any traveler that may pass through any checkpoint at the airport, it will be done in a paperless manner, right? So that was the objective with which this project was launched. And all these things will be done with the use of technology which is known as facial recognition technology. Do you remember the name? Facial recognition technology ka istemal kiya jayega to achieve this contactless and seamless processing of passengers at the airports, right? In the phase one, this project will be rolled out at two airports, which are Varanasi and Bangalore. And when in the next month, that is in the month of August 2022. However, in the next year, by March 2023, this plan, this project will be rolled out in five airports across the country, which are Pune, Vijayawada, Kolkata, Delhi and Hyderabad. All right. Now, under this project, there is something known as Digi Yatra Foundation. Now, this Digi Yatra Foundation was formed in the year 2019 as a Section 8 company. Now, what is the meaning of Section 8 company? Section 8 company ka matlab hota hai, the not-for-profit companies, right? And it was formed with the objective of creating the Digi Yatra central ecosystem so that the Digi Yatra project can be implemented efficiently, right? And there are various shareholders in this Digi Yatra Foundation. 26% is held by Airport Authority of India, and the rest 74% is held equally by the five airport limited, which are Bangalore, Delhi, GMR Hyderabad, Mumbai, and Cochin International Airport Limited. Right. So that's it about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. All right. It is a project for achieving contactless, seamless processing of passengers at airports. So yeah, it will be implemented in Delhi and Mumbai international airports in first phase. Is that so? In first phase, it will be implemented in Varanasi and Bangalore. Right. So this is incorrect. For creating the Digi Yatra central ecosystem, Digi Yatra Foundation was formed as a Section 8 companies under Companies Act of 2013, though ye bilkul sahi hai, there is no problem with it. So therefore, guys, the correct answer will be option C, only 1 and 3. Option C will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to National Clean Air Program, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Now, again, this is nothing new. It was launched in the year 2019, right? Then why we are discussing about it? Because a reply has been submitted by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change with respect to this program. And that is why it is in news, or isliye exam mein bhi pucha ja sakta hai. Right, so let's talk about it. Remember, this basically National Clean Air Program, it is a strategy. And as the name suggests, it is a strategy to combat air pollution in the country. Theek hai? So it is a strategy to deal with the air pollution problem across the country in a comprehensive manner. And as I told you, it was launched in the year 2019 by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, which is currently headed by Mr. Bhupendra Yadav. Bhupendra Yadav is the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Now the target under this program is to, reduce 20-30% particulate matter concentration by the year 2024. 2024 tak 20-30% reduction in the particulate matter by the year 2024 under this program, and it is currently being implemented in 132 cities across the country. 132 cities jo ki bahut zyada air pollution hai jahan pe, wahan pe isko implement kiya ja raha hai. Now out of these 132 cities, 124 are non-attainment cities and 8 are the million plus cities. These million plus cities were identified by the 15th Finance Commission. However, the meaning of non-attainment cities, इसका क्या मतलब है? So these are the cities where national ambient air quality standard is exceeded for consecutively 5 years. यानी कि जो standard है air pollution का, जितना होना चाहिए, 5 साल लगातार से उससे ज़्यादा है, right? And for these 3 cities, that is Delhi, Kanpur and Lucknow, which are one of the most polluted city across the country, air quality early warning system was launched under this program. And there are various social media handles through which public complaints are being taken by the ministry. Like we have Samir app, through emails they are taking the complaints, and through other social media handles, right? And then for monitoring the implementation of this program, there is a portal which is known as PRAN portal, right? PRAN portal. Now what is the meaning? What is the full form of PRAN? It is Portal for Regulation of Air Pollution in Non-Attainment Cities. Portal for Regulation of Air pollution in non-attainment cities is the full form, right? And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify incorrect statement, all right? It was launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change in 2020. Bilkul sahi baat. Nahi, not in 2020. 2019 mein launch hua tha. So this is incorrect. It is being implemented in 150 cities across the country. No, 132. तो ये भी इनकरेक्ट हो गया. एंड इट इज एनवाइसेज टू अचीव टारगेट्स ऑफ 20 to 30% रिडक्शन इन पार्टिकुलेट मैटर कंसेंट्रेशन बाय 2024. ये सही है, विच मीन्स 1 and 2 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन डी राइट, बिकॉज वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. नाउ प्लीज यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन द वर्ड इन द एग्जामिनेशन वेदर दे आर आस्किंग द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट और द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, राइट. तो प्लीज इस तरीके की गलती मत करके आना, बिकॉज अगर आप इसी क्वेश्चन में देखो तो ये दोनों स्टेटमेंट गलत है, ये सही है. तो अगर मैं करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट मार्क करूंगा तो ओनली 3 भी ऑप्शन में गिवन है, और अगर इनकरेक्ट चाहिए तो ओनली 1 and 2 भी ऑप्शन में गिवन है, राइट. सो इस तरीके से प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज इन द एग्जामिनेशन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, हु इज द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग कमीशन सेट अप अंडर द मिशन कर्मयोगी. नाउ कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग कमीशन की बात हम क्यों कर रहे हैं, व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज. इट इज इन न्यूज बिकॉज द कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग कमीशन हैज इंस्टीट्यूशनलाइज द कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग प्रोसेस अंडर द मिशन कर्मयोगी बाय लॉन्चिंग नेशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर सिविल सर्विस ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन, राइट. नेशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर सिविल सर्विस ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग कमीशन विच वॉज सेट अप अंडर द मिशन कर्मयोगी. नाउ ऑफकोर्स दिस ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन will help the capacity building commission for capacity building of the class officers under mission karmayogi, and it has been set up at the headquarters of capacity building commission which is located at New Delhi, right. And who is the chairperson of capacity building commission? It is Mr. Adil Zainul Bhai, and that is why I have taken this question, because ye pucha ja sakta hai. Adil Zainul Bhai is the chairperson of this commission, okay. So option C is the correct answer. And regarding this training institution, there is no much detail provided by the ministry. So agar kuch aur detail aati hai, that like who will be the chairperson, what will be the constitution, so wo sari cheeze we will discuss later. Moving ahead to question number 5, which ministry has organized the Udyamita Pakhwada? Pakhwada means 15 days, any festival which is organized for 15 days, right. To highlight the importance of enterprise growth and entrepreneurship development under non-farm livelihoods in rural areas across the country. So basically, Udyamita fortnight was conducted, not 15 days, 14 days, fortnight hota hai, theek hai? So Udyamita Pakhwada, kaun si ministry ne organize kiya tha? That is the question. Remember, it was organized by Ministry of Rural Development. Now under which scheme? It has been organized under Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, Day NRLM, which is National Rural Livelihood Mission, right? And from when to when? From 1st to 15 July of 2022, it was conducted, right? Now, why this Pakhwada was organized? So it was organized to highlight the importance of enterprise growth and entrepreneurship development in the non-farm sectors in the rural areas. Rural areas mein, jo non-farm sector mein enterprise growth और एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट का इंपॉर्टेंस है उसको दिखाने के लिए दिस वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड. एंड देयर वर वेरियस एक्टिविटीज व्हिच वर कंडक्टेड ड्यूरिंग दिस पखवाड़ा, लाइक देयर वर अ सीरीज ऑफ एक्टिविटीज अंडर वेरियस इंपॉर्टेंट इनिशिएटिव्स अंडर डे एनआरएलएम, लाइक स्टार्टअप विलेज एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप प्रोग्राम, वन स्टॉप फैसिलिटी, एसएचजी प्रोडक्ट्स मार्केटिंग, पीएम एफएमई स्कीम एटसेट्रा. एंड ड्यूरिंग द इवेंट रुपीज 11.91 करोड़ was dispersed through community enterprise fund to these enterprises through community institutions, right. And finally rupees 10.8 crores were released to self help groups under Prime Minister formalization of micro food processing enterprise scheme for seed capital, right. That is it, itna hi padhna hai. And therefore the correct answer is what? Ministry of Rural Development, which is headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh. And Giriraj Singh is also the Minister of Panchayati Raj, of course. And his Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, which is in Bihar, right? Question number 6 pe chalte. Which of the following statements is correct with respect to FDI inflow in R&D sector in calendar year 2021? Very, very important question. Isme se question aapke exam mein banna hi chahiye. So let's talk about it. So Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, has shared the data regarding FDI inflow in the research and development sector in the country in calendar year 2021, that is from 1st of January 2021 to 31st December 2021, right. Now talking about the data, so as per this data, India attracted a whopping $343.64 million FDI inflow in calendar year 2021, and this is 516% higher. This is 516% higher if we compare it to the calendar year 2022. अगर हम एक साल पीछे जाएंगे तो 516% ज्यादा है, right? Karnataka is top recipient among all the states, followed by Telangana and Haryana, right? And talking about the country, अगर मैं कंट्री की बात करूं तो which country was the top investing country? It was Singapore with total 40% share, followed by Germany 35% share, and then USA at third with 11% share. And there are 5 states in the country which has crossed 250% mark, right? Matlab, they have shown growth more than 250%, and these are the 5 states: Telangana, Karnataka, Haryana, Andhra Pradesh, and Tamil Nadu. Right? And finally, there is a company which is Daimler Truck Innovation Center. It was the top FDI inflow company. Sabse zyada kis company mein aaya? Is company mein aaya. Right? Daimler Truck Innovation Center. And 40% of the total FDI is ke paas hi aaya tha. Right? In the R&D sector. So that is it. And now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the correct statement. Okay? India attracted US dollar 343.64 million FDI. Yehi sahi hai. Pehle hi answer hona chahiye hamara. India received 200% higher FDI. No, that's 516%. This is incorrect. Telangana is the top recipient. No, that's Karnataka. USA is the top investing country. No, that's Singapore. And only Haryana has shown growth of more than 250%. No, there are 5 such states which have shown growth more than 250%. So, option A will be the correct answer because we have to identify correct statement here. Alright. Let's move ahead to question number 7 then. India plans to strengthen its partnership with Africa in 4 areas. Which of the following is not among the 4 areas? Now, ab ye baat kahan se nikal ke aayi? Theek hai, so there was a conclave. There was a conclave which was organized by CII in collaboration with Exim Bank. So the name of the conclave is this only: CII Exim Bank Conclave on India-Africa Growth Partnership. And Minister of Commerce and Industry, Mr. Piyush Goyal, has participated in this conclave. And during this conclave, he announced that India is planning to strengthen its partnership with Africa in 4 areas, which are solar power, defense, trade and military exchanges, physical and digital infrastructure, and 4th is healthcare and pharma. And he also reiterated that there are 4 pillars of ties between India and Africa. These are people, business, trade and government, right? So this is, guys, very, very important. I believe ye bhi aapke exam mein pucha jana chahiye. And now let's come back to the question. Iske alawa, there is nothing important from this conclave, from this news, right? So which of the following is not among the 4 areas? So solar power is there, defense, trade and military exchange is there, physical and digital infrastructure is there. There is nothing like social security, which means option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 8. Consider the following statements with respect to National Culture Fund, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now again, it is in news because regarding this, a reply has been submitted by the Ministry of Culture. Who is the Minister of Culture? Mr. G. Kishan Reddy. G. Kishan Reddy is the Minister of Culture and the Minister of Tourism as well. Right? So let's talk about this fund. Remember, it was set up in the year 1996. Bahut purana fund hai, it is nothing new. It was set up in the year 1996 under an act which is known as Charitable Endowment Act of 1890. Right? And its aim, matlab why this fund was established. So it was established to establish and nurture partnership in the field of culture and heritage with private and public sector, and thereby conserve, protect all the important monuments of the country and the rich heritage culture of the country. So as the name suggests, National Culture Fund, which means this fund is being used to protect, preserve and conserve the rich heritage culture of the country, right? And talking more about this fund, so remember, it is being managed by a governing council and an executive committee. This governing council is chaired by the Union Minister of Culture, and there are total 21 members in it, including 15 non-official members. This executive committee is chaired by a secretary in the Ministry of Culture, and there are 9 members, including 4 non-official members, right? And finally, since its inception, it has completed. There are 52 projects which have been completed under the under the National Culture Fund. All right, so that is it. Now let's come back to the question. It was set up in 1990 by Ministry of Culture. No, the year was 1996. It is being managed by a governing council headed by Union Minister of Culture and an executive committee. Ye sahi baat hai. And the executive committee is chaired by Secretary, Ministry of Culture, and has a strength of 9, including 4 non-official members from the council. Bilkul sahi baat hai. So therefore, the correct answer will be option B, only 2 and 3, because we have to identify the correct statement. All right. And now let's talk about question number 9. It is a mission being implemented since 2014 with the aim of development and conservation of indigenous bovine breeds, genetic upgradation of bovine population, and enhancement of milk production in the country. It has been, I believe, aapne identify kar liya hoga isko abhi hi, because with such objective, there is only one mission in the country, and that is Rashtra Gokul Mission. Rashtra Gokul Mission, right? But let's talk more about the question. It has been continued for 2021 to 2026 under Rashtriya Pashudan Vikas Yojana. But the question is, what is the total outlay for the extended period of this scheme? Now, I believe you have identified this mission, this scheme. It is Rashtriya Gokul Mission. And the total outlay, guys, for this period is 2400 crores. Option E is the correct answer, but let's talk about this mission in brief. So these are some of the broader objective of this scheme. You can read out from the PDF. But yes, overall, remember, mota moti yaad rakhna, development of indigenous bovine breeds, genetic upgradation of bovine population, and enhancement of milk production. These are the three broader objective of this particular scheme. Theek hai? It was launched in the year 2014 by Ministry of Animal Husbandry, Dairy and Fisheries. It is continued for the period 2021 to 26 under Rashtriya Pashudan Vikas Yojana. And the total outlay for this period is, guys, 2400 crores, as I already told you, right? And therefore, the correct answer is option E, rupees 2400 crore. Moving ahead to question number 10. How much amount per month is provided to socio-economically backward fishers family by the respective state or UT during the fishing ban or lean period under the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana? So there is a period in a year when the fishing is banned across the river, across the oceans, across the seas, right? In that period, the socio-economically backward fishermen families are provided financial support under Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. So the question is regarding this. This is a very, very important question for the upcoming NABARD exam, guys. Please focus here. So this support, as the question already told you, that this support has been provided to the socio-economically backward fishers family during the fishing ban or the lean period. That fishing ban period is also known as lean period. So that is nothing difficult or nothing different. So what is the support, by the way? So to all the beneficiaries of Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana who are socio-economically backward, the government financial assistance worth rupees 3000 per annum is provided, and the beneficiary's contribution is rupees 1500 per annum. So ye kitna ho jata hai? 4500 in the name of beneficiary jama hota hai under Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. Rupees 4500 is accumulated in the name of beneficiary under the Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. And during the lean period, that is for a maximum period of 3 months, 1500 per month out of this 4500 is provided to the socio-economically backward fishermen's family, right? So this accumulated amount of rupees 4500 is disbursed to each enrolled beneficiary by the respective state or UT at the rate of rupees 1500 per month during the fishing ban or lean period, right? So I hope this news is clear, and I have discussed Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana in very much detail during the government scheme session. So if you want to know about this scheme in detail, then you can search for Anuj Jindal government schemes. There is a playlist in that I have discussed in detail. And for the upcoming NABARD examination, I will discuss this scheme in future during the government scheme session, jo ki hamare Monday, Wednesday, Friday ko chal rahe hai. So what is the amount per month that is provided? So that should be 1500. Option B is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 11. Which ministry has released the Jan Samarth portal to provide various services to the citizens of India? Now, this is, guys, again a very important question because this portal was released in the month of June 2022 and ab ye PIB mein isko diya hai, PIB mein ye aaya hai, right? So, this portal was launched by Ministry of Finance. Ministry of Finance has released Jan Samarth portal to provide various types of services to the citizens of India. Now, what type of services are these? Number one, it connects all the stakeholders. Now, what type of stakeholders like are these? Beneficiaries, financial institutions, central or state government agencies and nodal agencies on a common platform. Applicant can initially access the benefits of 13 schemes, or he or she can know about the benefits of 13 schemes through a single platform, which is this portal, right? Guidance will be provided to applicants on checking the subsidy eligibility, ki wo subsidy ke liye eligible hai ya nahi hai. Auto recommendation of the best suitable scheme for the beneficiary, right? And finally, digital approval of loan application based on digital verification. So these are some of the services that will be provided to the citizens of India through this portal, which is known as Jan Samarth portal, right? And therefore, the correct answer is Ministry of Finance, headed by Nirmala Sitharaman. Option D is the correct answer. And now let's talk about question number 12. As per the latest annual survey of industries 2018-19, now remember, guys, abhi annual survey of industries 2018-19, it is not important. But yes, ye ek reply mein ye statement Ministry of Food Processing Industry ne di thi. Ministry of Food Processing Industry ne di thi, and that is why I have picked this question, right? So, as per the latest annual survey of industries 2018-19, so this is nothing new. Ye koi naya survey nahi hai, ye bahut pehle launch hua tha, and is survey ki detail mein jaane ki zarurat nahi hai hame. How much percent of total persons engaged in the registered manufacturing sector is contributed by the food processing sector? Theek hai? So, up for the upcoming NAVAD aspirant, this is very, very important question. This percentage is, guys, 11.22%. And there is no need to go into the details of this particular survey. That is not required. 11.22% is the correct answer. Question number 13. As per the National Mental Health Survey 2016, similar is the case with this survey. There is no need to go into the details. 2016 ka survey hai ye. Theek hai? But ye wali line, ye wali statement, minister ne parliament mein submit kari hai. So that is why maine ye question banaya hai. So, as per the National Mental Health Survey 2016, what was the prevalence of mental disorders in the age group of 13 to 17 years? Can you identify this percentage, guys? Yes, it is 7.3%. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 14 pe chalte. In how many districts across the country, maize development program is being implemented by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar? So, in how many districts this program is being implemented? So, this program, remember, is being implemented in 237 districts, and these 237 districts are in 26 states and 2 union territories. Okay, so option C is the correct answer. Question number 15. What is the agricultural credit target of Government of India for financial year 2022-23? So, I believe this question aapne पहले भी बहुत बार करा होगा, बट ठीक है, एक बार रिवीजन के लिए कर लो. सो फॉर द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2023, द एग्रीकल्चरल क्रेडिट टारगेट, व्हिच मींस द लोन दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर, इज 18 लाख करोड़. ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. लास्ट ईयर इट वाज 16.50 लाख करोड़ एंड दिस टाइम इट इज 18 लाख करोड़, राइट? क्वेश्चन नंबर 16. नेशनल मिशन ऑन ऑडिबल ऑयल्स ऑयल पाम वॉज रिलीज इन 2021-22 to promote oil palm cultivation for making the country atmanirbhar in edible oils. The mission targets increasing of area of palm oil from 3.70 lakh hectares to how much till financial year 26? Theek hai, to kitna 3.70 lakh hectares se kitna karna hai, right? So it is 10 lakh hectare. Option A is the correct answer without any doubt. And the last question for today, as per the National Wetland Inventory and Assessment 2011, developed by application Space Application Center of ISRO, what is the total estimated wetland area in the country? Okay, so can you identify the answer? It is 15 million hectare. Option B is the correct answer, right? So that's it for today's session, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's session. And NABARD ke jo aspirants hai, please gear up your preparations now. Please don't lose your hope. Abhi bhi bahut time pada hua hai, to jitni bhi cheeze aapne padh li hain, aur padho aur acche se revise karte raho. And please remember, continuous revision is the key to success, right? So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next session on Monday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.